Hey guys, I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and today we're checking out the new-ish OnePlus 3T. Its camera features, quality, and pitting it against my old, trusty, but still almost top of the charts, Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge. Who comes out on top? Well, the results may surprise you, as I sure was. Now, real quick, I always have to mention the obvious disclaimers. Yes, the 3T is a cheaper, more affordable device, but the S7 was released 8 months earlier. Plus, it's more affordable now. It once was around $700-$800, and it can be found around $550. The 3T is around $440 base model, so it's about $100 cheaper. First and quickly, let's compare specs. The 3T has more megapixels, but as I like to say, it's not the quantity, but quality that matter. And same goes with sensor size, pixel size, aperture, and more. Now moving on, let's first start with some photo comparisons. Everything is shot at highest resolution, HDR turned on, which by the way, the 3T has this silly HQ or HDR mode, one or the other, can't have both on. I did side-by-side comparisons and they looked almost exact same, with HDR being slightly better in my opinion at least, so thus I left HDR on all the time. I found the 3T seems to have a better dynamic range overall. Now this could be because the S7 likes to add that extra punch of contrast, so those details can often get lost in the dark shadows, and this is same with exposure. The 3T seemed a bit more balanced, while the S7 tends to overexpose, so also losing those details in the highlights. My last key note of comparing photos, the 3T looks softer overall, while the S7 looked tack sharp. This is possibly because Samsung processing tends to over sharpen the image, but I personally kind of like it. I'd rather have it a bit over sharp than soft. Next major category is video, and I could spend all day on this one, but since we don't have time, we'll compare the more popular modes and features. First, they both can shoot 4K 30fps, this is standard nowadays. Remember, all my videos are shot and uploaded in 4K, so click that gear icon to view in all 4K glory, and that way you can really spot the slight differences. Sharpness and resolution both look really good. Even the color saturation look really nice and about the same on each. As for exposure, again the 3T looks nicely balanced, great amount of detail maintained in shadows and highlights, whereas in the S7 is just so punchy with that contrast. We lose details in those crushed blacks and blown out highlights. In regards to color accuracy and balance, I just have to give that to the 3T as well. And it's funny because I look at the S7 image and I think it looks great all alone. But then I switch over to the 3T and it just looks slightly better with its colors. End of day though, with most of these tests, if it's a close enough call, it sort of comes down to personal opinion and which one you think looks better to your taste. Now next video test is slow motion, and as a major bummer, the 3T can only shoot up to 120fps at 720p, while the S7 can do 240, and that double frame rate really makes a difference. But to make the comparison fair, I retimed its shots to 2x. Both look too soft in my opinion, and two negatives I found, while the 3T crops in way too tight on the sensor, while the S7 maintained a wider field of view, but then my S7 had some glitching going on. More on this shortly, so basically they both aren't amazing. Another big test in my opinion, image stabilization. The 3T has both OIS and EIS, while the S7 only has optical. I did side-by-side tests, 4K as well as 60fps and 1080, some walking, some scootering around. In my opinion, they both actually look pretty similar, neither one really stands out from the other. I do have to say though, my S7 had more glitching going on like we saw in slow-mo, so that's not cool at all. For the front-facing selfie cam test, first up they say the 3T is fixed focus, which makes it look basically broken. This was just terrible and made all of my shots look blurry, soft, and basically unusable. Now sure, the 3T has a higher resolution front-facing cam, but if you zoom in and all those pixels are just blurry, well that doesn't really help. I do like the S7 has a much wider angle field of view over the 3T, which will help when squeezing in those big groupy selfie shots. Lastly, the 3T does, however, have fantastic EIS going on, while the S7 was much more shaky in video mode, so very clear difference there. Here's a quick audio comparison for you.
Hey, this is an audio test, the OnePlus 3T, test 1-2.
Audio test, Galaxy S7 Edge, test 1-2.
And another key test, how well do they perform in low light? Both look a bit noisy, and I'd rate the 3T a bit worse in photos, while the S7 is better at processing that noise reduction, but the trade-off is it might look a bit softer. Also, the white balance adjustment on the 3T is a bit slower to respond. However, the noise in video mode looked worse on the S7 than the 3T. Very interesting. Now for the last two tests, I wanted to share my thoughts on the camera app because, let's be honest, your experience with the camera is only going to be as good as the app. Comparing stock camera apps next to each other, I personally like my S7 app way better than the oversimplified 3T app. The 3T has barely any customization in its settings, and the UI is clunky and just non-efficient. It's not a deal breaker, but as others have mentioned, it's really annoying, for example, to have to swipe up on the screen or pull out the drawer to switch to video mode, whereas in the S7 has that full-time dedicated video button right next to the shutter. The reason this actually matters, in my opinion, are those life-altering moments. Milliseconds matter, and last thing I want to do is lose my shot because I had to do a couple extra swipes to actually start recording. Now, the other major issue I found with the 3T is its auto-focusing. I googled around and found it's actually a common issue, and I think OnePlus really screwed up on this one. I've been using the 3T for my other YouTube shots, and in these sample clips, you'll see how easily it can lose focus, struggling and taking way too long to try to regain focus, and then losing it again. Comparing focus to the S7 Edge and its dual pixel autofocus, it's lightning fast compared to the 3T. And lastly, don't forget about the 3T front-facing focus issue too. Okay, so let's summarize everything. In most of the tests, the 3T held up very well and even better than the S7 in some areas. And this was very impressive to me considering its cheaper price tag. However, due to that major focusing issue, there's just no way I could switch to the 3T as my daily driver. I'm always using my smartphone camera for my YouTube vids, and unfortunately it just won't cut it yet. I wish it had better focus, more powerful controls in their stock app, 240 frames per second slow-mo, and maybe a couple other things, but if you go with the 3T, you'll still be able to capture some really solid shots all around. And remember, this is all camera only. The phone itself is really fast, snappy, and awesome. Let me know down in the comments if you want to see a full review. Oh, and I also can't wait to test out that new Samsung S8 camera, so stay tuned for that. Now, huge thanks to GearBest for supplying me with the sample unit, and as always, I'll give you the link down below to check out their current pricing. Be sure you're subscribed and hit that bell to stay notified of more tech videos every week. And until next time, let's live authentic.